that obviously is being asked, and rightly so, is whether this changes in any way the dynamics of the impeachment trial that is going on and will continue to go on into next week. And for that, Arthel, I think the answer is no. This is obviously backing up much of the narrative that we've already seen laid out by the House impeachment managers. It's corroborating evidence more than anything else. And to a certain extent, it goes to what the White House has been saying all along about how the president felt about the U.S. ambassador to Ukraine, Maria Yovanovitch. And the president obviously has it within his right to have the people that he wants serving him as ambassadors, serving him in the ways that obviously make forward and put forward the best interests of the administration. The president obviously lost confidence in Ambassador Yovanovitch.
Here is a bit more from Chairman Engel's statement. He said, "I want to know what the State Department knew about it then and what actions have been taken. I'll use all the tools at my disposal to get answers I'm seeking from the department." So where might this
Mr. Engel is the chairman of a very powerful committee in the House of Representatives. We can certainly subpoena documents from the State Department to see how they responded initially to the idea that there may have been threats against the U.S. ambassador in Ukraine. And you would think that the State Department would comply with those subpoenas for documents, but we've also seen as this impeachment process has played itself out, Arthel, that is not always necessarily the case. So I would not be surprised to see hearings on this particular issue.
Yeah. you what you want while getting the therapy you need.
This is the best.